Okay, guys, so we have a bit of a struggle that might need troubleshooting, and that is, jumping up. And so we've got little Mango here.
And Mango is very new to us and to the situation, so don't get me wrong. This is completely, so many of you ask, can we see an untrained one? Can we see one that hasn't done it before?
And then we were like, let's do a troubleshoot.
From the start, here it is. From the start.
So literally, this is going to be the first session of working on jumping up. What can we do to transform this behaviour? Well, first things first, she's on lead. Now, being on lead, it means there's limits on how much she can jump on me. There's not many limits on how much she can jump on Lauren. But you know what? We're helping her out a little bit. And what we're going to use is we're going to use her daily food allowance to teach her there's value on the floor. Now, to start with, that probably just starts with a bit of drip feeding onto the floor, saying, you know what, whatever your 4 feet are on the floor, there's value coming at you, right?
So with her, knowing that actually even any sort of movement towards the food, any of it, and also knowing that she finds even getting the food exciting, just trying to be as calm as you can be when you're doing it and not trying to make it a huge event, I think for Mango is going to help. Just some of her daily food, right, Tom?
And to start with, there really can't be much of a pause between delivering the food, because in the window of a pause, she's probably going to jump up. So literally, we're just going to drip, drip, drip. And what you might find is you get moments of pause like that where she doesn't immediately jump up. Love it. You see, we're getting that moment of decision making right there. And what we can then start to do is open up the window in which she's got to make choices. So already we've got a dog that, as long as the window's not too big,
reloading with food.
we get a dog that actually is choosing to stay on the floor and saying, actually, there's value for keeping 4 feet on the floor.
Now, with Mango, just like Tom said, there can't be too much of a gap. With that in mind, Tom, I'm running out of food. Now, I want to make sure I've got enough of her daily allowance. Do you have food to carry on with?
I will grab some food.
This is good. So making sure that we've got enough of Mango's daily food. I know, it's here. There we go. Enough of her daily food. And you can see the problem is real. The problem is lively.
The problem is here.
Wow.
There we go. So what we're doing is we're just literally teaching the value is on the floor. At times, of course, she's going to jump up in this, and we're thinking progress, not perfection. But what I love to see is that we're seeing moments of just a pause, moments of a breath, moments where Lauren doesn't immediately feed, and we see that we get some we get some 4 feet on the floor. Now, the cool thing is this game that we're playing, it's very simple. It's whenever there's 4 feet on the floor, I'm going to drip feed food and I'm going to open up the window to work with you slowly. The other thing that you can do with this is you can use it to teach your dog not to jump up on people. So the way that would look, Lauren, is you'll throw one piece of food
this is good.
Towards me. And then what you'd look to do is for Mango to bounce back to you. And I'll just try and be as calm and as insignificant as possible. Lovely. And when she bounces back, you're just gonna feed again.
Nice.
Lovely.
Super.
Brilliant.
Wow.
So we're getting rehearsal of what we do want, and we're really kind of spelling it out. This is what we'd like
nice.
To happen. Now,
super
the more
girl.
Times that Mango spends
super
in the presence of
girl.
People and she's not jumping up at them, the more times she will the more she will choose not to jump up, right? They become more of what they do each and every day.
Wow.
So we can play games where they rehearse Super. Great stuff and they start to not jump up. So, you know, this behavior struggle, it's one that over the course of a few sessions, what you'll find is that this will get better and better. And what we wanted to show you is that is us working with a dog who's very, very new to this. And actually, over the course of that little session right there, we saw masses of improvement.
Now, so she's a dog who is always going to have exuberance. Yes. She's always going to have bounce. Yes. Oh.
Wow. Wow. She's always going to be creative in her responses to things.
And you've got to laugh because she's always going to be the type of dog that adds a spin to your games. Now, I bet that you guys own dogs just like this. I bet that you guys have dogs that do exactly this. And I know how many of you have asked to see a dog who really hasn't been trained. That's exactly where we start. And that's all we would expect in our first session and sessions. And really, that's quite a lot. Yeah. There's quite a lot there. And that's a whole, she's had probably, as she explained to you, she's had a reasonable meal.
Yeah, absolutely. And what we love there is that you got to see where it starts so that when you see the, you know, the more finished picture, you appreciate that actually it did not start there. So that's how we would troubleshoot jumping up. It really is an example of progress, not perfection. But you see over the course of one session, the amount of progress. Don't stay stuck in the story. Don't let people put labels on your dog of being untrainable. There's always a game for that. Go and have a play. Remember, game changers, whatever the dog owning struggle, there's a game for that.
If you haven't already, remember to subscribe to our channel
and check out our new 25-day online dog training challenge. Watch the videos, play the games, transform your dog owning struggles.
As a loyal YouTube subscriber, you can get a 70% discount through the link in the description below.
And if you haven't already, subscribe to the number one most transformational dog training podcast on iTunes and Spotify, the Sexier Than a Squirrel podcast.
And remember to follow us on Facebook and Instagram for more live teaching, video content, and free training using the links in the description. Blah!